I bought these super cheap iTag style Bluetooth trackers from Temu for less than 2 euros each. I don't plan on using these with the app mentioned in the manual. Instead, I want to use these to wirelessly control other devices using ESP32 and Home Assistant running on a server as a bridge between these Bluetooth tags and target device. If you don't have ESP32 port yet, you can order one from PCBWAY.com, who is sponsor of this video and many of my other videos as well. They have module store where you can order many kinds of modules and devices, which will then be delivered with your usual PCB order. These are quite popular things, and using the button to trigger things using ESPHome has been done before. But I still haven't found tutorial or forum post telling how to read the double click on these devices reliably without triggering the single click action as well. In this video I'll show you how to connect these iTag devices to ESP32 using ESPHome and detect single click and double click of the button. Those detected clicks will then control things in Home Assistant that runs on my home server. I have Wi-Fi settings and other default lines in this YAML file. What I'll describe next are things that I have added to it. They don't replace the default lines. The component PLE client is used to connect to the Bluetooth device. That component also requires ESP32 PLE tracker component, which I have included. PLE client component needs two parameters: MAC address of the device, in this case the device is iTag, and the ID that will be used to identify this specific Bluetooth device later in this code. I have also added something else in this PLE client instance. These iTags start beeping when connection is lost. That feature can be turned off, but it will be back on after replacing the battery or turning off the tag. I have added onConnect automation that waits 2 seconds after the Bluetooth device is connected, and then write 0 to characteristic used for enabling or disabling that automatic beeping function. This was application-specific part of the code, not something that needs to be done with every PLE device. Now this tag and ESP32 will connect when they are both powered on, and that's it. Nothing else happens. Next, it's time to add the sensor component that gets the, without knowing any better phrase for it, the raw button data sent by the tag. This sensor reads the data from specific PLE client's characteristic at specific intervals. I have set the update interval to never and notify parameter to true. This stops ESP32 from repeatedly checking the values from the PLE device, and instead, the PLE device sends a notification when the value has changed, and ESP32 can handle that changed value without unnecessarily pulling the device. That sensor's on notify automation is triggered when the tag notifies that the value of the characteristic has changed. That automation turns binary sensor on and 20 milliseconds later off, simulating a quick click. That binary sensor is defined in the next part of this YAML file. This binary sensor is template type, which is controlled programmatically instead of some kind of sensor or other physical device. Each time the tag sends information that button has been clicked, or the number 1 in the characteristic, previously defined sensor triggers 20 millisecond long click in this binary sensor. I have figured out that these specific tags update that characteristic once for a single click, but if the button is double-clicked, the tag will update characteristic third time immediately after the second update. ESPHome's binary sensor has on multi-click automation, which can detect series of certain length pulses and pauses and run automation based on those pulses. For example, I have one defined timing of on for at most 200 milliseconds and off for at least 1 second. That is description of single click, which I have set to toggle switch to off position. Second timing I have defined is 3 on pulses, shorter than 200 milliseconds, with less than 1 second off period between them. That describes 3 short pulses, which was what these tags send when the button is double clicked. That series of pulses runs this command, toggling the switch to on position. The switch that is toggled is another template type binary sensor that has defined name, so it will show up in Home Assistant. I can now go to Home Assistant and in Settings, Devices and Services, ESP Home and One Device. Here might be extra step if you have more than one ESP Home device configured. But here I can see FOB switch in sensors section. That was the name I gave to that last binary sensor. It is currently off and clicking the button on tag doesn't change it. But double click turns it on. Second double click does nothing. And single click turns it off. That works like I wanted. This can then be used in automations to trigger other connected devices as you wish. Simplest way to do this is to click plus sign next to automations and continue from there based on your own needs. Many things in ESP Home can be done with just a few lines, but this was a little bit more complicated. But I'm beginner when it comes to ESP Home, and I still managed to figure all this out in afternoon, so it's not too bad. I know this has been asked or requested multiple times in different forums. Hopefully people wondering the same thing find this useful. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.